Dear civil engineers, in this lecture, I'm just going to share that how we'll create, how we'll model our staircase in Autodesk robot. Okay, so to create a staircase in our model, we have to do something before creating our model. So here, first of all, I will by clicking here, I'll stop our that 3D view, and after that, I'll go here in view, then from here display. Okay, otherwise you can go from here and I'll go loads, and from here I'll uncheck the 3, then apply. Okay, so now see, we're seeing all of our that value. Now at which level your middle place will be? Here we have to create a level, so I'll go for Z direction, and where actually your middle point will be created. So from first of all I'll create that gate beam from stair 1 to from ground floor to stair 1. Okay, we'll create our staircase between them, and after that we'll duplicate that. So here 6 point, here 6 feet, and here total 16 feet. So the difference between the half of the distance will be 5, so total 5 plus 6, 11. So that middle point will be 11 feet, and I'll simply click here add, and see here one level I have created, so GF, then here one, after that I'll simply click apply, then close. So just see here now, one point have created here. If you see here, the another one point have created, okay, here. Now, by taking your mouse here, you are able to go here at structural axis by going that view. Now go structural axis and see here we are. Okay, now at middle, in that point we will create our landing. Okay, our middle landing. So to create that, I'll just go here slab, and I'll define another slab from here. Okay, that will be 6 inch. I'll consider our slab thickness that are 6 inch or 6 point or 7 inch. Okay, I'm considering that our staircase slab will be 7 inch here. That will be 7 inch, and that will be constant value. Our slab thickness will be constant value 7 inch, and here color, that is, it's giving here water. If you need to change that, you can change it. So I'm just giving that. Okay, after that, here change that level, so 7 or okay, that will be stair slab 7 inch, right? Stair slab 7 inch, so everything is okay. After that, I'll have materials, so concrete. Actually they have many materials, so this is the value of concrete materials. So I'm considering our concrete is 3.5. Here I'm just considering that, and after that I'll click add. Okay, and after that I'll close and see here another slab have created. So when it's done, from here I'll select shell, and I'll use that option contour. Okay, I'll use that option contour here, contour. Clear? So when it's done, now our first of all our slab, horizontal slab, that should not be, that should be horizontal slab first time, and here you know that we will create our staircase. So I'll just click here geometry, and as this is our staircase point, so I'll click on that point first of all. So see here we have created a point 23.88. okay, so 23.88 we have created a point, that is 23.88. okay, now in that direction I'll take what will be the width of landing actually. So that will be, I'll consider that will be 3.5 feet. Okay, so here that is okay. After that I'll come here and I'll click on it. Just see here that value is available here, and after that I'll just give here 3.5 5. Okay, and also I'll delete that value 3.500, and here all of that value are available. So what is the meaning of that? Our in y direction, that will be 23.88 grid point, and 3.5 feet will be, sorry, 3.5 feet will be in x direction from 0.0 point, and 3.88 will be x direction from 0.0 point. Then I'll click add. Just see, we have created another point, and if you see here, we have created here one point and here another point. Now I'll go in that direction. Okay, I'll go in that direction, and you have to consider, I mean, you have to understand what is the level of that point. So that is 33 point, sorry, here 33.4 in x direction, 33.54. okay, and in y direction, that will be 3.5, we know that. So 33.54, clear? So I will just come here and I will give here 33.54, and also I'll give here 3.5. Is it clear? 33.54 and 3.5 point, and I'll click add. And if I come here, just see here that point we have created all point, and after that I'll create on that point. Just see, we have created 4 point. When it's okay, after that I'll click apply. Just see, when I click apply, then we have created a point here. Okay, we have created a point. Just see. Now, what I will do, I can do two things. I can move that, okay? I can move that or I can copy that. So, first of all, I will close it. After closing that, I'll select. Okay, I'll select. And from here, I'll just go edit. And from here, I'll move. I'll use move or copy. So from that point, okay, from that point, I'll use that option copy. Okay, I'll select that point to copy here, and I'll move it here. Just see on that point. Just see. Sorry, I'll copy here, and see here we have create another copy of it. I'll close it at this time, and I'll escape, and I'll show it in 3D view. So I'll just go view. Just see here we have created a stair, I mean that slab, a stair slab, and here another one. So what would actually, I'll again select that, and I'll move it, I mean I'll take a copy here and here. Clear? And it will be easy, very easy to create that. So actually it's totally depend on you that how will create, how will complete your work. This totally depend on your technique. So after that I'll click here copy. Okay, and after that I'll select on that grid point, otherwise I can zoom it on that grid point here, from that point to that point. Clear? And also I'll click that point, and from that point to that point. Just see, it's done. Okay, I will close that, then skip. After that I'll select that one and I'll delete. Just see how easily we have created that. Now what we'll do actually, now we'll create our going or flight. So to do that, I'll close that. Again I'll go here slab, and that is okay. Okay, so that is okay. I'll use the rectangular, that option, rectangle, and I'll use the rectangle option, then slab 7 inch and shell. After that I'll select that point, middle of that point, on I've done a mistake, it shouldn't be horizontal. Okay, so again I'll click on that point, and I'll escape, I'll close, again I'll start. So that should be rectangle and shouldn't be horizontal. Okay, and this is okay. After that, here one point, and here another point, and in that point we'll create another point. Just see, we have created our one landing. How easily, just see how easily, it's totally depend on your technique. Okay, so again, when it's done, I'll click here, I'll click here, again I'll click here. Just see, skip, close, and go into 3D view. Just see, we have created our slab. Stair. So in easy way, we have created our stair. Okay, so I hope that was clear to you. And if I just go here, view, then display. Okay, so here bar panel, different panel, so in a structure or view, so they have many things actually. Color face, if you use that color face, then apply. Okay, so this is the color face, and after that in panel, mark with color. Okay, section, then apply. Just see, it's giving you the different color of different panel. Clear? So I think this is okay, and in this way you are able to complete your work. So thank you very much. Stay connected till next video, and in our next video I'll show you that how we'll assign load on our structure and how we'll replicate that. So thank you very much. Stay connected till next video.